Today I'm going to talk to you guys about the sport of hockey. No, not just regular hockey. I'm talking about hockey that is being played underwater. Yeah, you heard me right. I'm talking about the sport of octopus. Now, what is this sport? In principle, it is very similar to hockey, with the key difference being, of course, that it is played underwater. The general playing field for octopus is the swimming pool. Okay, let me first talk about what the sport is and how it's played and what all happens in this exactly. Similar to the sport of hockey, octopus has a puck. Like hockey has a hockey ball, octopus has a puck, and the players are given sticks. Now, the sticks are different in shape and sizes when compared to the hockey stick. This has a more wide base for the players to maneuver the puck in underwater. Now, there are two teams, of course, with 10 players each in their squad, and there can only be 6 players from each team at the pool at a given period of time. Now, the play starts with each team having all of their players standing against the walls of their goalpost. Now, they start against the walls of their goalpost, and the referee places the puck in the middle of the port, in the middle of the pool, and signals the start of play. At that signal, some of the players, depending upon the tactic of the team, swim towards the middle of the pool to gain possession of the puck, and then they start playing. Now, the objective of the sport is very similar to what hockey is, or any other field sport for that matter is. It is to drive the puck towards the opponent's goalpost and score a goal. Now, there are different formations, and it's very similar in formation and gameplay style to normal hockey, because there are defenders, there are midfielders, there are attackers, so there is no rocket science there. But there are certain rules which govern this sport in that sense. First off, given the fact that this is a limited contact sport. Because it's a limited contact sport, the players cannot have real physical contact with each other. First of all, the puck that you are trying to maneuver towards your opponent's goal, you can only touch the puck using your stick. At any given point in time, if you come in contact with the puck through any other part of your body, it is considered to be a foul, and the opposition team is given free possession of the puck. In other cases, when there is a severe physical challenge by one player to another, the player who has committed that infringement is put out of play for a given period of time. Now, there are again rolling substitutions in the sport, which means there is a certain amount of tactic that comes into play during the sport. The biggest thing which I think is really fascinating about it is that the players who are playing in the swimming pool, obviously they're playing underwater, so they don't have the scuba suits or the oxygen tank to be able to breathe underwater. So they need to hold their breath while they're playing underwater, and they need to come up from time to time to catch hold of their breath and go back down. So that tells us that there is a lot of thought that is being put into each play and each player doing something underwater, because they need to strategize and analyze for how long they can hold their breath and then come up, catch their breath back, and then go back down again. So yeah, it is a very fascinating sport. And how I got to know about this sport exactly is through a teenage scuba diver in Pune. Her name is Khushi Parmar. She's one of India's youngest octopus coaches, and she's played octopus at the national level. Now, she was the one who introduced me to the sport, and at the international level, this is a very serious sport. Well, there are world federations who govern the sport. There are international tournaments which happen. India is not very popular on the international scene yet, but I'm hoping something will happen soon. But for now, I think I've given you guys something new and interesting to do when the next time you go to a pool. Remember the name, octopus.